Today we're in John chapter 10, and Jesus makes some radical statements about himself. In fact, listen to what he says in verse 14. He says, "I'm the good shepherd, and I know my sheep, and am known by my own." He says, "I'm a shepherd. I'm the good shepherd, loving, protecting, feeding, caring." And his words brought a lot of controversy. And Jesus was known for creating controversy over and over again. And he just kind of comes out and says, "I'm a shepherd." And they would be familiar with Psalm 23, "The Lord is my shepherd." And so the religious leaders of that day, at that time, got very uptight. In fact, listen to what they said. The Jews surrounded him. They came all around him. And they said to him, "How long do you keep us in doubt? If you are the Christ, tell us." And Jesus answered them, and here's what he said. "I told you, and you do not believe. The works that I do in my Father's name, they bear witness to me. But you do not believe because you are not of my sheep. As I said to you, my sheep hear my voice, and I know them, and they follow me." Jesus makes that radical statement that he's a shepherd, and they want to force the issue. "Tell us plainly who you are." And Jesus says, "You don't know me because you're not my sheep. My sheep know me, and they hear my voice, and they follow me." And this is an amazing thing that is true for you and for me here in the Gospel of John. We follow him because we know him. We know what he's like. We know he's caring. We know he's protecting. We know he's guiding. We know he's leading. We know he's a good shepherd. But we also, through his word and by his spirit, we hear his voice in so many ways. And I would pray that today you'd take some time, hear his voice, and once again commit yourself to following him. And here's the reason why. Jesus said, "I'm the good shepherd." He's good. And if you follow him, you find his goodwill for your life.